I think most of the team players over here are well experienced and well played, both well played teams, right? So hashtag your favorite team on the comment below, and you can see the first ban coming up from Claude, and the second ban has been done
All
by
brands
Sunny.
are already done. Bro, the both teams are fast enough. They want to finish match as much fast as possible. There's Claude, then Selena, then Esmeralda, then Natalia. They've already fixed what they have to pick, and they'll come the Diggy.
Right, it's quite an entertaining match. We can see that they are already planned all the things. They are already worked on their homework, what they have to ban and what they don't want to ban. So DG has taken Diggy right now, and I don't think so. It's a good option for the enemy to take Atlas. I think we could see an Atlas pick over here from DG. Oh, there goes Carmilla and Kufra for the pain. And the
So,
witch has been locked down by Carry. Would they go
do you
for a
think
carry?
Carmilla is a bit unusual pick in the match?
No, but actually
Carmilla.
Pain always like goes with Carmilla. They know that Carmilla pick is their strong point, and whoever plays the Carmilla, I think Sid solo plays Carmilla, and they try their best to secure Carmilla in any condition possible. I think.
Yeah, that's some
I
inside
think.
info here that this solo is a Carmilla player.
Oh, so my bad then. It must be someone else. But someone from Pain plays really well on the Carmilla, and they have always preferred, and they have always gone for this Carmilla pick in every possible comp. I think in this tournament there was just one or two games where Carmilla was banned, and that was because Pain, they didn't want Pain to pick it because the Carmilla, the player from Pain who plays
Yes,
Carmilla.
they roster can utilize Carmilla well, so that's why they wanted to ban it.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so there comes the ban, third ban from their side, Atlas. I was expecting a Jawhead or Sylvana ban, but there comes a Harith. So that's how pro teams on the both side have banned AWP heroes. Especially they have banned the damages. There is no only single tank ban, all other bans are damage.
You know the way they have banned Harith. You know, if a proper Carmilla uses her ult, plus if there is Kufra in that same ult, plus if Harith uses the ult, it would be a massive damage for Team Pain. So that was a very good ban, Harith, which Team DG has banned. I think they just want to finish off the game as soon as possible. So the picks are all done, and we could see Hanzo, which is a very, very rare pick, you can say,
I think
in this tournament.
this might be the fastest ban pick phase in history.
Yes, seriously. I mean, just pick one here, just ban there, just ban there, just ban there. And we were talking just about the first ban, and they have already finished the ban.
Yeah, it was like they
And
decided, okay guys, we know we are going
you
to
have.
we have met each other a lot of times in rank, so we'll definitely we know exactly what every player is going to ban or play.
Yes. So they know how, what they will pick. And unusual picks on the side of Pain, there's Carmilla and Faramir is not that unusual, but Carmilla and Hanzo. So, yes, that should be
I
interesting
think
how Pain will be playing.
there's a wonderful thing which is going on, which we can see Tetsuya as India's number one Ling. And on the other hand, Hanzo has been picked. I think Ling has a very good advantage over Hanzo, right? But let's see what happens. You can see a normal rotation, 1-2-2 rotation by DG, and the same. Oh no, I think Pain is going all five mid. This is going to be an epic thing, which I think they are trying to make Hanzo take the buff of Ling. As soon as the Ling takes down the buff, it's going to be
Yes,
a difficult thing.
as soon as the buffs came, Hanzo is stacking his first skill, and now he's coming for the enemy buff. He will be possible. Okay,
And he
I
has
think Ling
made
just pushed on time. He just pushed
that.
Retri on time.
Right,
Hanzo wasn't able to do it.
That was a GG gameplay by the Ling, because if Ling doesn't get his buff, it would be a difficult thing for him to do
And
that.
now DG are paying them back that yes, you came for our buff, now we will came for your buff, so let's
Right,
make
they are
sure that
aggressive right now. But there goes the first
card.
Is gone, and yeah, I think they are also going to die. So
it's just 1 minute in the game, and just 1 minute in the game, and look at that.
Look at the Carmilla's damage. Oh my god, this is going to be an interesting game. And as you can see, the DG is falling behind. And on the other hand, you can see the team Pain has been doing good right now. The goal difference is not that much, but I think DG would struggle a little bit on the start. I hope team Pain doesn't lose their rhythm, which they are going right now. So there's a gang which is going on. I think Faramis will die. No, he won't. I think he's going to back down from the bot lane. And as you can see, there's going to be a mirror rotation on the top and the bot. Both the towers might go down. Chao is waiting in the bush. He's waiting for the correct time. Maybe they want to take down the mid tower, not the top tower. That's quite interesting. That's something which we have not seen that much. Pain is going for the bot tower, and Hanzo is using his shadow to get through the mid lane. And Ning has come to the mid, and
Did you just notice that DG have took the bot tower? So there's going a fair trade of mid versus bot.
Right, and you can notice that Curium is helping Witch get farm, but sadly
again.
Oh my god, look at the way Demiser got through the players and killed out the MM, which is
is going for the Hanzo body here. Cho is going for the Hanzo body here. He will get it, and now I think Hanzo will be dead. Yes, he will be. Maybe he will be.
Not dead. I think Chow is in trouble right now.
Hanzo baited him really well, but I think Chow will escape.
Right, and there's a small mistake by Pain, which has cost them 2 kills right now. The goal difference is also almost the same. I think they'll go for the turtle right now after this, because one of the team members they have already cleared the lane, so now they're playing objective wisely. So they're going for the tower. I think Faram is
okay. Despite of many attempts by Pain to destroy the farm of Ling, to disrupt it, Ling is still farming. Like, nothing is gonna stop him from farm. No matter how many heroes you took, how many CC you are, he will be farming.
But on the other hand, okay, the Kufra has not gone through the mid bush. That is quite not a good thing to do. He has to check the bush.
Okay,
and
there
I
comes
think
the Carmilla gang.
Carmilla dies on the spot. And that's how, if you lose the rhythm, you lose the game. That's how it is done. So, guys,
many things to learn from this gank, what that happened in the mid. That's how you have to gank from the both sides.
Right. You can see Hanzo is harassing Ling, and Ling has almost lost all his HP. But
I think
the
Bruno is dead. Killing spree for the
Oh my god, look at that. They almost killed that.
Did you just notice on the top what happened? And now it's what happening in the bot.
Right.
DG is silently pushing from the top, and now they are not even knowing it.
Right.
Pain is not even doing it.
Now they're going for the mid push, I think. So no, the witch is going to take down a kill, I think so, over here. So this is going to be a 2 kill for witch. Okay. So the goal difference is getting higher and higher, a little bit slower, but they are both are playing very aggressive game right now. And Ling, on the other hand, is waiting for, wanted to kill Hanzo, but Hanzo manages to get away. So the tower trade has cost them a lot.
Actually, DG has experimented well with the emblem talents. They are using 2 focus mark on their team. So yes, any of the skills will do. And focus marks stack on the enemy team. If 2 team players have the focus mark, then damage would be multiplied in the power of 2.5. So that's going to be a huge setback for Pain here.
Yeah, they're going for the turtle right now. So we could see an engagement over here with the turtle. I think turtle has been taken down by Faramis. And there goes the tank. They are like DG's, like no matter what we get, we'll kill it. Normally players don't go for
that. Was nice ult. Nice ult by Faramis.
Oh, they could go for a Diggy. Diggy kill. Will Diggy die? Oh no, they forgot.
They will try to kill Diggy. But I think this is zombie. Okay, it's not zombie.
There was hands.
Kamila is in trouble. Kamila is in serious trouble now.
Right.
I think she will try to kill Cho, but yes, there is three of them. Okay. Kamila will... Okay, what do you think?
No, I don't think Carmilla could kill. Oh, okay. She killed. Killed her. Oh my god, and Diggy killed Carmilla. This is turning out to be a quite funny as well as an interesting game, guys.
I was not thinking Carmilla would be able to capable of killing Cho, but she killed. And then Diggy, okay, you killed Cho.
Yeah, right, now look at the way Paramus is getting into the using his ult for himself. I think he's going to take down the tower. Paramus is a pick which we didn't expect that much, but it's turning out to be a good one. On the other hand, the kills ratio is 11:6. DG is leading on kills, and the tower trade is almost the same, and the goal difference is also not that much. As you can see, DG is good at killing, but Faramis is very good at reviving them, right? So
actually, Kamila is doing the best job,
going into every single thing, and she has been. That is why Carmilla is one of the best picks in MPL. You know, in MPL, Carmilla has been picked a lot, and they're trying to save the top tower. Hanzo is going from the mid lane to the top lane. I think we could see another gank which is going on over here, and Diggy, will they take
again? Again, Ling just put the red tree right time. He didn't even miss the single buff.
Right. Look at the way Gary has taken down a lot of heroes. And there goes Faramis. Double kill. Will it be a triple kill for Gary? Getting triple kill for Gary is... Gary is farmed. They had to...
I should point out one thing here. That DG may have the early game roster, may have the early game, but Pain, if Bruno get farmed, then Pain would be such a pain in DG's ass that...
Right. They would be. But the thing is, Carry's farm right now is 6k and Bruno's farm is around 4k. There's 2k difference in their own farm. So
yes, that's why DG is dominating a quite bit. But if Bruno got farmed, they didn't gank Bruno enough. And if Bruno got farmed, then that should be a problem for DG.
Right. Let's see what is going to happen right now. And on the top, you can see Pain has been taken down as red buff.
And I seriously like the Carmilla gameplay. She's playing with the NSAT talent. She's playing with the tank emblem, and she's really sustainable enough. She killed Cho. He's one of fighter assassin thing in the game, and she killed Cho on the dot HP. So something we should be worried about when enemy picks Carmilla. So there are ganks going on, and Hanzo is trying his best.
MK. I think MK does.
And there comes another gank from the Pain, but they will retreat. And DG is doing quite good with the push. Cho is pushing from the bot. Ling is trying to push from the top. He has all the buff. And now DG is harassing the Hanzo shadow. Carries back to the farm. And Pain is much in a miscommunication now with what they have to do. They are playing defensive, but playing defensive won't give them any benefit over the DG. And I think DG would be planning another gank on them. Yes, there is a gank, and now I think Carmilla would be dead. There's too much of sustain, but more than sustain, there's enough damage. There comes a proper ult by Faramis, and more proper ult by Witch, and then here comes Cho. So I think that Pain tried to dominate in the game, but I think they are done for good. DG is dominating the game now. Witch is now in the hyper carry mode.
Yeah. Witch is like, what, 8 kills, 2 deaths. Damn. He's dealing a lot of damage, man.
No, actually, they actually Payne did a mistake. They didn't gank Witch enough, and on the other side, DG ganked Bruno enough. So Bruno is somehow less on the farm. And to be honest, I would say, and it's true that Payne took Hanzo as a purpose.
Yeah.
Hello. Yeah.
Yeah. So, sorry. I got down. Okay.
It's all right.
So, and actually, Payne took Hanzo for a purpose. Purposely, they took Hanzo to steal this farm, the Ling farm. But
right.
Actually, it's not gonna happen because Ling is so much proficient in the farm. He never missed a single buff.
Right. Look at the way Kufra is getting melted down. And on the other hand, Tetsuya has killed.
Okay, I think Cho is struck. I think Cho is struck again with the Carmela. And now Cho is running away from Carmela. You know, he can't kill her in a lifesteal mode.
Oh my god, his body came with his soul.
That was something unusual. His body came to die from the hands of DG.
Man, this is amazing.
He has come, please kill me also. I don't want to be soul dead, I want to be fully dead. Okay, a nice kill by Faramis here. Now zombies in the battlefield. I think Tetsuya will try his best. Okay, then Tetsuya will be surrounded by zombie, and he got devoured by zombies as well.
It's so funny to see zombie, right?
Yeah, there was the zombie mode, like PUBG. So here comes the zombie mode, and then Tetsuya died. All zombies on him.
Top lane will be gone right now. Oh my god, can Hanzo take down Diggy? No, he was not able to take down Diggy. I think double kill by Kufra.
It's a double kill.
Yes, it is a double kill by Kufra, and I think this one is harassing him. Chow is trying to harass him, but by the time
here comes the kick by Chow.
I think they will take down the Lord. There goes
okay,
the tank.
Dead.
Right. Let's see what happens now. I think Carmilla is doing an excellent job. Faramir's ult is getting connected very well. On the other hand, Hanzo is also doing pretty good. So in every gank, Hanzo can actually initiate by going down.
I fear that Bruno isn't even having a 15 stacks on his jungle item. On his Raptor Machete, he doesn't have enough stacks, I think.
Bruno has a 7k farm, which is quite good at this point, because once he gets all his gears, it's going to be a nightmare for a DG. As you know, he can resurrect with the help of Faramis, so it's going to be a non-stop football kicks from him.
Okay, that was nice ult by Tetsuya, but I think he had to retreat as well. He can't kill tank now.
I think they have to do something about this, because this is going to go a lot higher than what we expected. It's already 14 minutes. It's already 15 minutes. 5 minutes more. Will they be able to hold down it for 5 minutes and will be seeing a second draw or a GG comeback by Team Pain? Let's see what is happening on the top. Thamizer is poking. As you can see, they are doing pretty well. And there goes the ultimate of Faramis. And will Tetsuya get shut down? Tetsuya
wow.
is down.
That was a nice damage on the first skill of Faramis with the second skill combined.
But that innovator tower is gone of the mid lane, and that's not a good sign for them, right? And as you can know, Carmilla is charging up so much, and if they manages to connect two or three ults together, Payne would get an awesome advantage. Will they be able to hold down the match for five more minutes, guys? What do you think? Comment down below. Will they be able to hold down the game for 5 more minutes?
There
and
comes
there goes
the malefic
there
role
goes,
for Bruno, and
there,
that's what I was talking about. There comes the malefic
there
role for Bruno.
The three players of Digi and only Thamizer is left, and they have four players of pain, and this is going to be a pain for DG. Will it be?
Okay, now there comes the turn for Themizer as well.
Okay, will
the Lord is coming up, the enhanced Lord, and now Pain will surely try to take the Lord as fast as possible. DG.
Okay, there goes.
They will try to kill Tetsuya. Tetsuya left. So what do you think? Will they still go for Lord or?
Is killing Tetsuya more important or taking Lord? What do you think?
Yes, they are running behind Tetsuya as well. See, you can... Okay, that was a nice quick hit by Bruno. But somehow, DG stopped them.
I think what they should have done is taking down their buffs and all. Because now DG is trying to take the Lord. And if they manages to take the Lord, it's going to be an issue for them. And Carmilla is... poking down. I think Themizer is in trouble.
Sacrificing himself.
I think this is going to be a very good match. Oh my god, look at the Farahan's ult is so GG. And Themizer is going to die. I think, no, he manages to get away from it. And Carmilla is chasing him so badly. And who got the Lord? I was so out of it that I was not able to see who got the Lord. But
actually,
I think
Pain shut it down.
So that's a GG gameplay by Pain. Pain is in the pain. They are literally giving up Pain for DJ, right?
Again, Carmilla is making Cho run away.
There's only 2 minutes left on the clock. Will it be a draw? Guys, comment down below. This is going to be an interesting game. The Lord is in the mid. Carmilla is in the mid. And as you can see, Faramis is in the mid. And they have two players, which is one tank, one fighter, and one support, trying to take down the Lord, which is actually a time waste for them. But it's 18 minutes. Only 2 minutes left for them to come back. This will be the final gank for DG or the Pain. Will Pain make it a draw or will Pain make it a fully comeback? Oh, DG. Oh, I think Diggy is going to die. No, Diggy manages to survive.
Did anyone realize that Tetsuya is split pushing?
Yeah, but I think this one has an eye on it. No, what do you say?
Yes, okay. Tetsuya realized that he is needed on the enemy on his base now. Carmilla initiated really well. Now her HP is paying off.
Nice ult by Faramis.
Okay, so here we see the zombies on the field.
1 minute to go.
We are going to see a lot.
1 minute to go. Let's see what DG can do actually.
Oh my goodness. This is a big mistake from Pain, and I think they will do a mid push, and that is going to be a very.
No, it's still. Some time is left, let's see if Hanzo can do something to hold the line. I don't think he will be able to do anything. Oh my god, they tower dive and kill.
Okay, now they will be pushing without minion. Yes, they are going to sacrifice their HP as well.
Oh, with the 20 seconds remaining.
Oh my god, the GG got the game.
A GG game by DG. Oh my god, this was so freaking great.
On the clock. Not on the clock, that was like 10 seconds were left probably.
Seriously? one small mistake and that mid gank of Pain really cost a lot. DG has won the game in 20 seconds. They just had to hold down the game for just 20